Slancha. Kate Middleton dazzles in £1,595 designer emerald gown as she downs a pint with Prince William at the Guinness Storehouse in Dublin to toast the end of their first day in Ireland. The Duke and Duchess of Cambridge tonight shared a pint at the Guinness Storehouse in Dublin to toast the end of a successful first day in Ireland. William and Kate enjoyed a pint of Guinness at the historic Dublin Brewery of the Irish Stout, with the Duke toasting his hosts in Gaelic, raising his pint and saying Slánchan. William appeared to sip his a little more enthusiastically than his wife, but Kate was still game enough to have a taste at the reception hosted by Britain's ambassador to Ireland Robin Barnett in the 17th floor Gravity Bar. The couple met a range of people from the creative arts, sport, business and charity sectors at the major visitor attraction in the Irish capital, which tells the story of the famous drink. The Duke and Duchess are following in the footsteps of the Queen, who visited Ireland's top attraction a number of years ago. They were greeted by the British ambassador Robin Barrett, who is hosting the party. Kate changed into a new outfit for the evening, and wore a £1,595 glittering emerald gown by trendy designer The Vampire's Wife for the first evening reception of the historic three-day visit to the country. The couple shook hands with dozens of people on the first day of their tour and are expected to continue to do so despite the ongoing coronavirus threat, based on advice they are being given. But they following guidance from Public Health England and the Department of Health and will continue to assess the situation. There are fears the couple's tour of Ireland could be overshadowed by his brother Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's return to the UK later this week. The couple, who are now living in Canada, will be attending the Endeavour Fund Awards on March 5 in London while Prince William and Kate Middleton are in Ireland. The couple were welcomed to Ireland today by President Michael D. Higgins and his wife Sabina, who said, "Delighted to welcome you. You've had lots of exciting things happening in your family." William and Kate, in a dazzling emerald green dress by The Vampire's Wife, were welcomed to the spectacular bar on the 16th floor of the Guinness Storehouse by the ambassador and his partner Agnieszka Kepka, before being introduced to groups of guests from film and TV, sports, sustainability and environment, creative and cultural Ireland, education and research, charity and uniformed services. They included Game of Thrones star Liam Cunningham, who played Davos Seaworth in the HBO series, and Misfits actor Robert Sheehan, comedian Deirdre O'Kane and actor Sarah Bolger and Orla Brady. Speaking afterwards, Liam said he had met the Duke before at an after-party for the War Horse premiere at Buckingham Palace. "They are total sweethearts," he said of the couple. "They are gorgeous, they are beautiful people. They are incredibly charming. They are much too classy to say whether they watched Game of Thrones, but he came over and said, 'Liam, you need no introduction. They are fantastic ambassadors for the UK.'" The royal couple also met inclusivity campaigner Sinead Burke, who was one of the forces for change chosen to appear on the cover of the September issue of Vogue by their sister-in-law, the Duchess of Sussex. Both William and then Kate chatted to the teacher and activist before being handed a pint of the black stuff each by Sainé Naupu, captain of Ireland women's rugby. Their three-day tour will focus on the themes of reconciliation, youth, culture, sustainability and the environment, and we'll see the couple visit the counties of Meath, Kildare, and Galway. At the event, William also addressed the guests from the worlds of sport, film, television and the armed forces in Irish, calling them De Oyinuazel – ladies and gentlemen. "Catherine and I are delighted to be here tonight and are both very grateful to Robin for his generous words," said the Duke. "Ireland is a country that we have both heard so much about, so we are really excited to be here with you to see it firsthand for ourselves. In coming to the Guinness Storehouse, we are retracing the footsteps of my grandmother, who was shown how to pour the perfect pint here in 2011. Ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you, it is not often that I find myself following the Queen to a pub. But I am looking forward to testing for myself the theory that Guinness tastes even better in Ireland than overseas." William continued, "Thank you for all that you do to support the very special relationship between our two countries. It has been a pleasure to meet so many of you this evening who demonstrate the breadth of our connections across the arts, sports, uniformed services, education and research, and charity sectors. We value it as we do your friendship and are committed to strengthening it further. The Guinness Storehouse tells the story of the famous Irish tipple, from the brewing process to the brand's history in Dublin, and is Ireland's top international visitor attraction, welcoming 1.7 million people in 2019. Almost a quarter of visitors to the Irish capital cite the home of Guinness as their main reason for visiting the city. William and Kate talked about coronavirus as he chatted to emergency workers at the reception hosted by Britain's ambassador to Ireland, Robin Barnett. He asked Joe Mooney, an advanced paramedic with the National Ambulance Service, "I bet everyone's like, I've got coronavirus, I'm dying," and you're like, "No, you've just got a cough." Does it seem quite dramatic about coronavirus at the moment? Is it being a little bit hyped up, do you think, in the media? He asked. By the way, the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge are spreading coronavirus. He grimaced in mock horror. Sorry. We're keeping an eye on that, so do tell us if we need to stop. The couple shook hands with dozens of people on the first day of their tour and are expected to continue to do so, based on advice they are being given. A royal source said last night the couple were following guidance from Public Health England and the Department of Health, and that meant business as usual for now. "This is a discussion we have been having, and everything we are doing should continue as usual," said the source. Prince William and Kate began their first official visit to Ireland for a post-Brexit charm offensive, as they also laid a wreath reading "May we never forget the lessons of history" at the Garden of Remembrance in Dublin. The couple received a round of applause in the garden, which is dedicated to those who fought for Irish independence, as members of the crowd cheered "Welcome to Ireland," and Kate smiled and waved back at them. They then attended a short ceremony at the site, where in 2011 the Queen laid a wreath in a significant gesture for Anglo-Irish relations. Kate and William were greeted by Mr. and Mrs. Higgins at their official residence before enjoying refreshments including Barry's tea, Shamrock shortbread, oat biscuits and lemon drizzle cake, made by the in-house chef. The Duchess looked stylish in an emerald green Catherine Walker coat, an Alessandra Rich dress and £17,300 Asprey London Daisy Heritage earrings, as she and William walked through the grounds of the Arizona train while joking and smiling with their hosts. Walking with the President's Burmese Mountain Dog, Broad, they gonged the peace bell, which commemorates the 10th anniversary of the Good Friday Agreement, before viewing The People's Acorn by artist Rachel Joint, which was unveiled as part of the state 1916 centenary commemorations. The Duke and Duchess later met the Irish TOISH Leo Varadkar and his partner Dr. Matt Barrett, during which William joked about whether he should put in his postcode as he signed the visitor's book at Dublin's government buildings. Earlier, the couple flew to Dublin Airport on a commercial Aer Lingus flight with dozens of residents returning home, business travellers and tourists. In brilliant winter sunshine they walked down the aircraft's steps and were greeted by a small group of dignitaries led by Britain's ambassador to Ireland, Robin Barnett. The couple will return to the UK on Friday, meaning they will miss Prince Harry's Endeavour Fund Awards in London, which the Duke of Sussex will be attending with Meghan Markle, as the couple prepare to step down as senior royals at the end of March. William attended the inaugural ceremony in 2017 but has not been for several years. The two couples will then be reunited for the first time since Brexit for the Commonwealth Day service in London on March 9, which will be broadcast live on BBC One and across the BBC World Service. At his official residence, President Michael D. Higgins invited the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge to sign the Distinguished Visitor's Book. The royal couple also spent some time with Mr. Higgins in the President's study before the bilateral meeting in the drawing room. During the meeting, Mr. Higgins was joined by his wife Sabina, Mr. O'Leary, the Irish ambassador to the UK Adrian O'Neill, and Claire Power, the President's advisor. Kate and Will were joined by the British ambassador to Ireland, Robin Barnett, and Simon Case, the Duke of Cambridge's private secretary. Mr. Higgins and his wife Sabina accompanied Kate and Will to the peace bell. The President explained to the couple that the bell was unveiled in 2008 by then-President Mary McAleese to mark the 10th anniversary of the Good Friday Agreement. The bell, dating back to the 19th century, is supported by two oak trunks which came from Shane's Castle to Maine in Coantrim and from the Glencairn area in Co Dublin. The couple then rang the bell. Mr. Higgins also pointed out the sculpture The People's Acorn by artist Rachel Joint, which was unveiled as part of the state 1916 centenary commemorations. One of the president's dogs, Broad, also accompanied them. During their discussions, the royal couple spoke about Brexit and the challenges of climate change. A spokesman for Mr. Higgins said, "The couples discussed the close ties between the people of Ireland and Britain and the importance of continuing and deepening close relations between all of the peoples of these islands." President Higgins, Sabina and their Royal Highnesses spoke of the challenges ahead, including the implications of the UK's departure from the European Union and the importance of continuing to build on the foundations of the Good Friday Agreement. They also discussed the global challenges of climate change and biodiversity loss and the urgent need to revisit the fundamentals of how we organize our economies and societies if we are to tackle these existential threats in a meaningful way. The importance of removing obstacles that inhibit young people from building their skills and realizing their aspirations for a truly fair and sustainable world, and the particular importance of responding to the vulnerabilities of young people was among the other topics discussed. When William and Kate arrived at the Garden of Remembrance, they walked along the edge of the open space's large pool, created in the shape of a non-denominational cross designed to be inclusive of all religions and creeds. Crowds had gathered along the perimeter fence and a cheer came up when the couple were spotted by the spectators who had been waiting patiently for more than an hour. The garden was designed by Daithy Hanley and the section where the wreath laying took place featured a large sculpture by Oisin Kelly, based on the theme of the Children of Lear, the Irish story about four children turned into swans by their stepmother jealous of their father's love. The floral tribute was laid at the base of the towering artwork by two servicemen and the couple stood in contemplative silence for a minute, eyes fixed on the wreath. On arrival, the Duke and Duchess signed the visitor's book, using a table commissioned by Ireland's Office of Public Works especially for the monarch's visit, before posing for photographs. After a few moments of smiling to the tune of a barrage of camera clicks, the Duchess laughed and turned her hands to the sky as if to say, "Is that enough?" The Duke joked, "Who blinks first?"